it says a lot about our kids. It says a lot about our team's character and our team's fight. And I don't want to sit here and sound like that guy and that cliche, cheesy guy. But I'll tell you what, we were tested. You know, we were tested over the weekend. It stunk to have to wait from Friday night and the bad taste that we all had in our mouths from Friday night. But our courage and our mentality and our physical kind of fight was tested. And I told them before the game that I don't think I've done a good job preparing them throughout the season, maybe for the fight. You know, we focus so much on being good at soccer and possessing. But college soccer sometimes is a fight, and it's just a battle, and it's a scrap and claw and things like that. And I think, you know, as a result, sometimes we play like we're focused on being good at soccer, but are we prepared to battle? You know, and I think that starts with me. And something we talked about coming into today, and I think without a doubt, our kids did a great job. And I'm happy for Tori. I mean, you know, scored that great goal. Hannah did well. Good little push ball. I think it was from Caroline or Bono. Nice to have, you know, Caroline back on the field for us. It's an important win for our record and our standings and all that. But it's an important win for the spirit of this team.
You mentioned a lot on Friday about their mentality just not being where it needed to be. What did you do over the next couple of days after that to get their mentality where it needed to be?
Well, I think I said a lot to them Friday night about that, both at halftime and after the game. And you can't beat a dead horse, you know. So Saturday's conversations became about them and all the things that we need to do to win this game. And a lot of that came down to mentality and mental approach. And then today and before the game, we talked about fight. We talked about this is a test today. And at halftime, we told them so far on the test, you have an A. We have 45 minutes left, and let's see what our second half and overall game grade is. So, again, they answered the bell, and I'm happy for them.
Does Coach CeCe Cobb, does she lead the league in grass stains right now?
She leads the league in, yes, just spending lots of time in a horizontal position. She, without a doubt, leads the league in it. Leads the league in flopping, leads the league in just appearing to be done for her career. She leads the league in all of it.
But she gets back up.
But she gets back up, and we always know she's going to get back up. We don't even wonder, worry. Like, CeCe's fine.
You go into the break, you know, no score yet. You knew you were in for another grinded out game. What were you telling them at the break at halftime?
Exactly, you know, this. We fought for 45 minutes, right? And so far, so good. But 45 minutes isn't a game, right? We got to keep doing. I mean, I don't think we needed to change much at halftime because I thought, you know, what we were trying to do and our game plan was decent, you know, in that first half, and it showed well, and it was a pretty even game, and at times we were possessing the ball, and that was our goal, to try to make it a soccer game and not such a physical battle, but we had to be prepared for the battle. So we just said, hey, you have an A at halftime, but guess what? We've got 45 minutes, and you got to go again.
Was this college soccer in a nutshell? I know you had that 6-0 game the other day, but you had 2-1-0 battles. Is this what college soccer really is?
This is college soccer, and this is the SEC. This is what, you know, obviously this is their first year in the league, so we don't have a rivalry with Missouri, but it's a league game, and every game matters. And, you know, we learn on the one weekend, you know, you can have very mixed results. And if we don't show up every moment, like you said, we had the Mississippi State hiccup, you know, but if we don't show up every single time to be good at soccer, but also to fight and battle and scratch and claw, we're going to get bitten.
Thank you.
Thank you, Coach.